The cold blue water of the Salish Sea is unlike anything I have ever seen, and beneath the surface, a kingdom of animals that are seldom encountered. Today, the crew and I will be venturing to the uninhabited Doe Island.
Whoa, this pocket's full of little snails. Look at all those little guys. Oh, look at this.
That's called a sea lemon. A little slowly here, you can be very gummy.
Oh, come here, buddy.
Sometimes you can find these and they're real bright yellow. That's why they're called sea lemons. And they also have these very distinct little black specklings all over their backs. Yeah, it's like a big gummy lemon.
All right, here we go. Bye, little guy.
Come on, lucky rock.
Whoa.
Whoa!
It is a huge prickleback. I believe this is a rock prickleback, and I can tell that based on the distinct stripe marking right there on the front of its head. It is a fish. It's not a true eel at all, despite the fact that it really looks like one. Okay. See those distinct stripes?
They do.
That's how I was able to identify it as a rock prickleback. They can grow to be about 3 feet in length. They can actually breathe air. They breathe underwater with their gills, and then when the tide goes out, they can stay out of the water for several hours breathing air. And I think at this point, it's probably safe to say we can release this prickleback back off into the ocean.
Out of my hand.
Oh my goodness, look at this.
What, can't see?
Oh! Look at the size of that sea star.
Whoa.
And it's purple. What, have you ever seen a sea star that big before?
No, I've never seen one that purple either, wow.
That is a first for me. Oh my gosh. Guys.
What?
This is one thing I'd hope we'd find.
Is there a bigger one?
No, look at this. Ah, I got it. Oh, look at that.
What is that?
That's a gumboot.
It is actually a type of mollusk related to snails and slugs. And I think between the two of these, we have found our feature creatures. This is the largest sea star I have ever seen. And this is one of the largest species that you can find off the Pacific coast. It is the biggest sea star I have ever handled. Check this out.
Ooh.
See all these little white things that look like spaghetti noodles? Those are called tube feet. Now, they have thousands of these, and they're used to slowly move over the surface of rocks when they're underwater. Now, I know in past episodes of Beyond the Tide, we've shown you guys the little bat stars and a couple of smaller species, but this thing is about as big as my face. Now, one cool thing that we do know about sea stars is that if they lose a limb, it can regenerate. It's called caudal autonomy, and it will eventually grow that limb back. All right, I'm gonna put this back into the bucket, and let's bring out our big star. You ready for this?
All right, guess number two, let's do it. Whoa.
Look at that. This chitin is very unique amongst other chitin species. Now, the one that we showed you earlier had these distinct valves that ran across the length of the back. This variety does also have those valves, but they're covered in this thick, rugged skin. Now, this is very tough, very durable. Not only helps keep them camouflaged, but also protects them against potential predators. Now, just like a slug, they have a foot that's right in the middle here,
okay.
That big area down there, and they also have a mouth, which is tucked in underneath here, and inside that mouth is a radula. Now, radula is kind of like a scrapy tongue, right? It's covered in these little teeth, and they use that to drag across rocks where they feast on algae, which is their primary source of food. So this is an herbivore. We definitely need to return this creature back to the water and hopefully up underneath a big, strong rock. See, look at it from the side there? That's like a giant PacMan. Also kind of looks like an alien creature that would maybe suction onto your face, but it's not gonna do that. They also do not bite, so I have nothing to worry about. They are not venomous, they are not poisonous. This is a completely safe species to handle if you happen to find one in the tide pool. Now, this is the largest chitin species in the world, and they can grow to be 14 inches in length and weigh as much as 4.5 pounds. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave, stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure.